What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Let's Play Xenoblade Chronicles X. We're back here in Diagon Alley, or Armory Alley, rather. And we're going to pick up some quests, I think. The last episode, we pretty much opened up the ass end of this game where we can do whatever we want. We joined the Blades, and now we should be able to use any of these terminals, right? Booyah! Holy shit, son. That's a lot of quests. Social, bounty, gathering, bounty. Can we take all of them and just start working toward all of them? Find Miriam to help further research. Do it. Can we take all of them? God, I hope we can. Once you use Miranium, so more Miranium. Yes. Can we just... I think we can just take them all, I hope. Hopefully there's no limit here. The tyrant is interfering with Frontier Nav expansion. You asked for help defeating Serene, the Lost. Sure. Now we are looking to conduct further research, reproductive, blah, blah, blah. Please bring us some ZZ Rabbits. Okay. Done. Brass Suds are interfering with data problems. Let's go defeat the troublesome Indigens. Okay, do that. Sakuraba Industries has requested that you require some rapid data. Totally. Got it. We require crush rings. Further details on a strictly need-to-know basis. Okay. Cool. A tyrant is giving the Harriers a hard time. Help them hunt down Archibald the Revolutionary. Okay. I like how the big tyrant enemies... I'm thinking tyrants in this game are similar to the enemies that had, like, the big red names in the other game. They were, like, considered the harder versions of the enemies and stuff. I don't remember what they were called. They were called tyrants in that game, too, huh? They were. Wow. Okay. Anyway, we need somebody to bring us acorn abacuses. Got it. And we need suede filet. All right. Customers demand steak, damn it. We need to provide them with steak. All right. Here we go. Whoa, we already have some of the items. That's fantastic. So, we gathered a suede filet and delivered it to the diner chef. Oh, I guess just from doing it, we don't actually have to deliver it. That's fine with me. Saves me time. I like that they made the quest thing have a hub. Sweet, there's even new ones since I already did some of them. Cool. Food development using mirror supply fruit is underway. Gather materials for research. Done. Partners in pearls. We're looking for like-minded people to help gather Sanilac pearls. All right. Done. All right, well, we've done one quest already, guys. We did it. We're so good at this game. Or we're just lucky that we've collected one of the things that we needed. All right, so this fucking game, what are we even going to do? Are we going to start talking to everybody or what? Let's inquire about how to overwhelm our foes. If that's your goal, you want to topple them. You'll never miss a topple foe, and the effect is obscenely powerful. But to set up the topple, you first got to stagger. Now shut your yap hole and remember this. Once a foe has been staggered, if you hit them with an art that has the topple effect, you'll always topple them. Nice, right? But an even more powerful way to control your foes is with a scale's bind maneuver. They may actually let you pilot a scale one day, so in anticipation of that, remember my words, and it could be a while, so write it down. Follow a stagger with a topple, and if you're in a scale, it's stagger into bind. Okay. Fair enough. Don't know if I'll remember that, but at the very least, it'll be in the memory banks for later. When you get used to using your secondary cooldown strategically, you'll be able to challenge secondary or stronger foes. Rookies panic and use all their arts as soon as they are ready to be cast. This is a serious matter of concern for me. You see, some arts are more effective the longer you hold out. Watch their cooldown gauges carefully to see what I mean. You're the one responsible for setting your own arts, so you should try to strive to know all their effects at their primary and secondary cooldown gauge levels. Yeah, see, I noticed that there was, like, different levels when you have it all the way charged up or whatever, but I didn't actually look into what that really means. I'll have to start getting used to that. Yeah. Anyway, are we going to spend today's episode just walking around talking to people, or what? So the east gate is open. Well, don't worry about a thing. If any of those engines attempt to attack, I won't let a single one through. Cool. Alright. What I'm trying to see is if there's... Like, I noticed in the last episode... Like, let's talk to Eleanor real quick. Yes. Inquire about Blade missions. Your training just ended, but you're already being sent out to track down Nelson's missing team. Commander Vandam must have been taking quite a shine to you. That means a great deal of us as Blades, but it makes such quests please up to one of the tasks. Nelson's team was in the southeast part of Armory when we lost contact. I wish you the best of luck in your search. Oh, but I should mention one thing. If you're willing to pursue pertinent ultimate missions at a time, look at the... Yes, I am. I'm doing that already. But my thing is, I'm trying to say is, in the last episode, we kind of discovered that they have the connections thing like they had in the in Xenoblade Chronicles with the, like, different NPCs connect to each other, and it levels up your social thing, and it helps with bonuses and stuff. I don't know if this game has this yet, but I think it might. Wow. I'm just not sure which NPCs are eligible to be on that list, or you have to wait till a certain point. I don't know. You guys might have to explain if that's a similar thing in this game. Are you worried about me? Oh, thank you. I'm touched by the concern, but I'm fine, really. Maybe it would be better if you posed that same question to the people of New LA. I am sure there are many who are troubled by something, but don't consider it significant enough to make a formal quest to Blade. All right, cool. One thing I want to mention real quick. If you couldn't tell by the way I'm talking right now, I am hopped up on coffee as fuck. At work, I had some coffee today, and I am not a coffee drinker, by the way. So you can imagine someone who doesn't really drink coffee drinking coffee. Probably not the best idea I had today, but you know what? I'm alright with it. From here, I can get some arena. Okay, you're nothing important there. But seriously, drinking coffee and Funky G, as wired as I felt after drinking it, I don't know if that was a good idea or not. What's the question mark for? See, we should explore the town before we do anything. Look at Christy. She's badass. Or Kirsty. Sorry, Kirsty Alley over here. It's Funky G, right? You damn right, baby. How you doing? I like that style you got there, that bra showing under your jacket. Oh, good. I've been looking for you. The name's Christy, or Kirsty, with a K. I'm the operations manager for Frontier Nav. Oh, so I'll be seeing a lot of you, huh? Naki requested that I brief you on the whole Frontier deal. Sound good? Oh, brief me all you want, baby. And then maybe you could show me your briefs. Tell her that you already know all about it. Now let's just listen. Oh, somebody got a heart. Excellent, I like your curiosity. Always remember that Frontier Nav connects us to the land. I guess the heart thing is similar to, also about Xenoblade Chronicles, where you have your, connection to your own party members as well. Unlike the rest of Mira, it takes dedication and curiosity to really understand. So then, first lesson, there are several different types of data probes that can be installed at Frontier Nav probe placement sites. It's vital that you keep desired application in mind, because each type of probe yields different effects. And what's more, placing the exact same type and grade of data probe in neighboring sites will amplify the effects of each probe. Now I can stand here and make you listen to a long, drawn-out explanation, but I think it's better if you just try out each one for yourself. Alright, well, I guess we got a mission out of there. The probe professional. Alright, mark it down. Set this mission as your navigation target? Sure! Secondary missions for the win. Remember the data probe you installed out on the East Gate plane? Sure. Good, I can see why you're on Nagi's short list. If you ever need to verify its exact location, just access the segment map with your comm device. I'll point out a pair of placement sites in the plane that has the West Gate that you can chain together on the Frontier Nav grid. Head there and install a data probe in each side, okay? But I don't want just any probes installed there. You'll need to change them to be the same type. That's how you get the chain amplification effects. You can change the data probes with your comm device. Just touch the corresponding site on the segment map. You change probe, you can take your pick from all the unused data probes you got. Do you have any? You do have unused probes, right? Here, take a few mining probes just in case. They're on me, but don't go spreading tales of my generosity. Your assignment is to travel to 2 specified sites, blah, 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 to make it all 3. It's all proof. Dude, she talks a lot. Here, he'll figure it out. It's all much clearer in action. Yeah. Alright, that was a lot of more talking than I care to read. As much as I'm feeling like blah, blah, blah right now. Anyway, let's keep walking around talking to people and see if we can get some more stuff in here. Yeah. Sure, ask her about the provisional government. Provisional government himself, the Director General Chausson. Don't tell me you thought that Blade was running this whole city by itself. Blade handles the fighting, but the provisional government manages the city. It's a very clear division of duties. Duty. She said duty.
Did you
duty.
Hear?
Did I hear? Did I hear? No, I did not hear that team got wiped out, but now I know. Alright, man, I kind of want to just explore the city, to be perfectly honest. I really, really do. Because it seems like there's missions around the city. Oh, we got a landmark discovered. Okay. Mimisum Maintenance Center. Alright. I don't know if talking to everybody is worth my while right now, is it? You support staff, blah, 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 message center, commercial station, doctors, one play, surgery capacity, you can visit one like. No influence, but some chapter, not shy, end of a roll, kind of cut yourself away, this internal damage. Cool! Yeah, I really, really have a hard time not talking to everybody. I will talk to everybody. Run, bitch, run! Alright. I'm kind of trying to use the map to see notable things that we need to maybe stop by and see. Like, what's this purple thing over here? Oh, is this the elevator to get? This is the elevator, huh? Wait, is it? Let me see. Elevator. Hauling elevator. Oh, okay, yeah, so it is the elevator. So we're like in the upper area. That's right. We took like a lift to get here. That's right. Kind of want to just keep looking around. You never know what we might find in this town. Kind of just want to keep looking around. Kind of want to, huh? Just kind of looking for red question marks at this point. Called the elevator, and then I'm not going to wait for it. I'm impaciente. Now, someone told me I could run around and jump farther. I kind of learned that in the last episode on my own. I don't have high enough level for this yet. No. That's right. I remember that now. Yeah, someone mentioned that to me in the comments. I'm like, I think I kind of discovered that in the interim, like near the end of the episode, last episode, where I could just run and jump like a goddamn champion. Anyway, oh god, don't jump down there. The music fucking kicked in when I started running too. Division Drive, alright.
I see.
I remember, well, I don't know if it's the same in this game, but when you discover new areas, you got a bunch of experience in the last game as well.
Just speaking for
I don't know if that's the case yet, but I'm doing it anyways. I'm kind of just looking around at this point. I'm probably going to go out to the same way we went out in the last episode, where we fought that tyrant. I'm going to go that way and probably do these probes, because I think that's the direction I need to go. A lot of people to talk to around here. You guys will have to let me know if talking to all the NPCs is really beneficial. For the social aspect and all that, that big web of lies. You have to let me know, because I'm not going to go around and talk to all the NPCs right now. That's just time-consuming as fuck. But what I will do, is I'll go talk to this red fucking question mark over here. Sadie! How you doing, Sadie? What's up, girl? How you doing with them short shorts? Excuse me. Sorry to bother you. I know you're terribly busy, but is there any way you might help with a rather urgent request? I promise I won't take more of your time. Heck, I don't have much of my own to spend taking up yours. Sorry, getting off track. Anyway, I know I should be running this request through official channels and all that, so I'm sorry. But there's just no time. I'm desperate at this point. I'll literally take any help I can get. Not to say you're just anybody. You're great! Look, I know I must sound completely bonkers. Just hear me out, okay? That's all I ask. Sure, what do you got? Really? You're going to listen to me? Yeah, I already said I would. Now tell me what you need. Oh man, what are the odds that the very first person to ask would help me out, huh? Like 9 to 1? I'm shy, you see, and I'd about worked myself into a panic thinking I'd have to keep approaching strangers, what with the staring and the awkwardness, and yeah, so I need your help to deliver some supplies to a blade team in the field. I'm a mechanic, you see, specializing in scales. I tend to head up a lot of important projects. Did I sound braggy? Just fucking tell me what you need! Anyway, I just got a call from a team that's always been really nice to me. They asked me to bring some supplies so they can do a field repair of their scales. Apparently something called a whimsical duo gill attacked them after they left on a mission, and now they're stranded out there. I pride myself on customer service, will be. But me wandering around outside the city is bad idea. Bad idea. Especially with the whimsical duo gill that broke their scales still kicking around. Much as I wanted to help, I'm just... This girl talks way too much. I thought of the 4 scales lying with me. I've broken my heart. So I gathered some adventure-y stuff and left town, but then kind of panicked about what to do next. The only sane plan I could come up with was asking someone this... Dude, shut up! Anyway, I know I should post this to Mission Control. Just give me the mission to shut your mouth. God. I'll set it later. I don't have time for rules, man. I can't just stand around filling out paperwork and cutting red tape or whatever. Oh, and I'll pay you, of course, or actually the leader of the team you'll be rescuing will, I hope. At any rate, they'll be in trouble, so if you get these supplies, they might really appreciate it. Totally. Thanks for shutting up for 2 goddamn seconds so I can walk away. Walk away, girl. Walk away. Alright, start heading toward them yellow things and start doing this probing. I'd rather do a little bit of action for the rest of this episode, or at least to start. Probably not going to go with the main quest for at least a little while. Now, when it comes to side questing and stuff, I usually will cut that kind of stuff, like the travel time in between out. I will show the fights I do and all that. But to start this game off, I'm probably just going to show everything that I do because, well, we're going to be doing a lot of exploring, which will be brand new. Stuff that we haven't seen before, so I'd rather show all of that exploring off until we've uncovered the map and done a lot more of these probings and all that kind of stuff. Start off by killing one of these because I feel like it. But yeah, I'd like to show most things to start off this playthrough. Like, just not have to cut anything. Until we fully explored a lot of these areas, I would love to just show all of my first impressions of exploring these places. So, similarly, like I did with Xenoblade Chronicles, I explored the shit out of every area, like, to the ends of the earth to explore exploration. Like, I was very thorough. I found most of the secret areas. In fact, I think by the end of the game, I did find all the secret areas. Not easily, mind you, but I did find them all. I did every possible quest that I could find. I mean, I'm sure I missed some along the way, because they were all not easy to activate and all that. Wait, what's going on over here? What are you? Are you... You might be a quest I have to do. Let's fight these things. Fight them. These actually might be a group of enemies we have to fight. One of the quests I have. I'm hoping so. That'd be nice if they just mark enemies that you have to fight for quests. So you don't have to go find them randomly. But anyway, my point is, for questing, I'm gonna try and integrate it through in the. I know I kind of said it in this. I just realized I kind of contradicted myself, huh? I think in the last episode I was saying that I would probably try to separate the episodes a little better between questing and fighting enemies, or and doing the main story. I can't promise I will do that. It's gonna be hard to do that with not knowing what's coming and how much helpful doing the quests are and stuff. So, at least to start, it'll be kind of integrated together into episodes. So, like this episode, we may waste a lot of time just doing side quest stuff. So, I mean, if you really don't want to see it, you know, tune out now. But for the most part, I would stick around until I get used to playing the game and start. Until fighting enemies and all that, and all the leveling kind of becomes stagnant, and we're kind of stuck at higher levels and only leveling up a little bit at a time. I mean, at this early point in the game, you should see my progress, see how good I get at playing the game and all that. This is the point at which, part of the point of the playthrough, you should still be watching to see progress until we get to, like, major Quest Fest episodes where all we do is quest for an entire episode. And like I said, I'll try to separate them from each other. Maybe even mark the episode's name as literally a questing episode. I'm gonna try. But again, I will reiterate. The beginning of this playthrough is gonna be simply integrated with the story and the quest, because it's all gonna go together in this early part of the game when we're doing a lot of leveling in the early part of the game. Okay, did we just kill that whole group of enemies? I don't see another exclamation point, so I'm not sure what the point of killing those guys was. They had green exclamation points, man. They were begging to be dead. I don't know if that was just one group I had to kill, or if that was a complete not necessary thing I just did, but they're dead now. It doesn't matter. Alright, so here's one of the probes. We could have actually teleported out here, I believe. Fast travel. But I kind of wanted to just walk out here naturally to start. Alright, so the next yellow one is over here. Oh my god, dude, we can fucking traverse this land like a goddamn champion right now. I love this. Oh, there's a quest thing out here, too. Nathan! You don't know Nathan, Nathan? What are you doing out here hiding behind the bushes? Oh, there's two guys. Or you're with a girl. They're just having a conversation behind a bush, you know. You know how that is. Just chilling behind bushes, making out and shit. Please, Monica, you gotta understand. His blades, our first priority is coming home alive. And as one responsible for this team, I have to take the path with the least amount of risk. So you want to give up all this his life to save ours? Oh, this is a girl talking now. So you want to give up his life to save ours? Pathetic. Look, if you don't want to go, that's fine. I'll find Connor alone. Oh, somebody's missing. Uh-oh. Here's the friend thing getting combined again. Monica, that's crazy. Will you please listen to me for a second? Sounds like a love triangle to me. Huh? What is it? If you're out here, I'm guessing it's because you're a blade. In that case, let me ask you something. Should an entire team risk their lives to rescue one single member? Or should that team run back to New LA like a pair of sniveling cowards and wait for reinforcements? Whoa, personally, I'd probably go for the rescue. That's just, unless it was like super dangerous and it was like just me and one of the, I don't know, two people looking for a third one, I'd probably just go for the rescue, man.
See, you've got guts. What if our friend dies while we're sitting on our asses back in NLA? What then?
And if the two of us go missing as well, how does that help Connor?
This is difficult to ask, but would you head north to Sickle Rose Rise, or Sickle Rock Rise, and see if you can find an interceptor named Connor? He's part of our team. We got separated on a survey job, and he hasn't come back.
Why don't you go? Send me out there. Bitch, please. Fine. I'll do it, but I'm not doing it yet. I got stuff I'm working on.
Thank you. I know it should be me going instead, but we got beaten to a pulp when our survey mission turned into an impromptu copper sinicula hunt. Honestly, we're both at a loss here. As you can probably tell, I'm afraid if we go, we'll just invite more trouble. I'm sorry you had to see any of this, but know that I really appreciate the help. We both do. As soon as we know Connor's location, we'll do our best to rescue him. Please help us find our friend.
All right, well, okay. Now I know what we must do. In the meantime, fuck you too. Let's go ahead and do a probe. Wait, I thought the probe was like right here. Or, no, I was heading towards it still. What were these? These are, we don't need to kill those. I'm just gonna move on. Moving on. We're not gonna kill everything right now. Unless we have to collect something from one of these guys, which we might. I'm just not sure. what drops what around here yet. I won't worry about it right now. I'll just kill things as I see fit. Let's just start heading toward where we need to go. Heading toward the probes, baby. I'm not sure why that other yellow one's a yellow marker is there, just because those are the other, that was the other probe that we already did. Yes. Anyway, in the meantime, we will collect all the blue things that we see. Wasn't there one right here? Screen messing with me? I love the jumping. It's so fucking awesome. That leap is fucking badass. She jumps like a goddamn champion. The gravity here must be amazing. Okay, those enemies, too hard. Stay away from them. Alright, I think one of the probes, we are very nearby. In fact, aw man, is that probe down there? In the middle of that army of scary enemies? I'm not sure if we can do this probe, but I'm gonna try. Aw man, there's a big dude over there. Can we just install it and run away? Oh, I see. We just mash the A button and we're good. And booyah! Field action succeeded. Another probe in the bank. Shorty, what you drank? I think it's the same kind of probe as the one we already did. I actually don't know. Solidate probe memory and then change it to mining. Oh! I see. So, how do we change it? Or do we just do this one? Solidate probe and then change it. How do we change it? I'm not 100% how we change it. Target? No. No. Don't target. How do we change it? Do we have to click it on the map? So we're here. Change probe. Okay, I'm using my gamepad, by the way. We want to change it to a mining probe. Confirm change. Aha! Wait, can I do that on the map? Hold on. This one? Can I just, like, click the one and make this a mining probe? Boom. Okay, cool. You can do it on the map. You don't even have to be in the area. That's actually pretty cool. Cool. You can just look at your damn map screen on the gamepad and do it. Sorry that you guys don't get to see what's on my gamepad, but as far as I know, you can't really record what's on the gamepad. Sad story, I know. But c'est la vie. Sickle Rock Rise. I'm just going to stay away from all enemies right now, especially giant ones. We are in an area that is full of enemies that will immediately obliterate us. I probably shouldn't even be out here risking this, but I'm taking a chance to do my dance. Better lose those pants. Don't run into me, big enemy. These big enemies are scary. It's like a giant ostrich-looking thing. I'm kind of scared being out here. At the very least, I'll set up a fast travel for this area. And then we can come back here later. This fucking world is huge, by the way. I love this. Look how fucking giant the Brontosaurus motherfucker is. Man, this game's awesome already. I just love jumping around. That's the best. I wish it was this smooth in freaking Xenoblade Chronicles original. This is smooth as hell, man. I love it. Stay away from all things. They will murder me. I know it. I'm not sure what enemies will aggro if you get too close. I mean, I imagine there's got to be some that just aggro the fuck. Get aggro as fuck if you get too close. I'm just collecting blue fucking gems for days right now. Are we high enough level to take out level 9 enemies right now? I'm a little scared to try, but maybe we should take a shot at it. Actually, you know, before we even do that... Oh, fuck. Never mind. Well, guess we're going to take a shot at it. Brash sewage. Guess we're taking a shot at it. Boom, bitch. See if we can topple this motherfucker. Yeah, topple. Toppled, son. Oh yeah, we got this. We're level 7, 8, 6 right now, so a level 9 enemy did worry me a little bit. He might do some good damage to me, but we already got him over halfway dead, so I'm not particularly worried. Yeah, ever since we went ahead and racked up a third party member, battles feel less scary. Can't wait till we can get a fourth party member. I wonder who it'll be. You think it'll be a male next time? I wonder if I could already have a fourth party member and I'm fucked up by not going to do that first, whatever that is. Anyway. Not sure if we got what we needed out of that guy, but let's go ahead and install the probe first. And then we'll murder these exclamation point bastards, whatever they are. Field action succeeded. Now, we gotta go in here and make it a mining probe, correct? Mining probe? Done. Wait, now done. Alright. Yay, we did it! Quest completed. We gotta go talk to the girl who started the quest, but that's fine, we can do that. In the meantime, let's murder this thing. Kill two birds with one stone, or two swids. Sewids? Are they swids? Not sure what to call these things, man. Also, I did the wrong attack first. Oh, my bad. I meant to topple this guy. Sorry, we're doing pretty good damage. Let's fuck him up with the gun. Better lose those pants. Better do my dance. Perfect romance. Getting bromance. Kill the exclamation point bastard. Get him. He's almost dead. Get him. I pressed it too late. Sorry, he did. Give me what I need, sir. Succulent meat. Squid fillet. I think that's what I needed, right? I think I got one of the items I needed for the quest. Does it matter what level the things I'm killing are? What's the red thing for? I'm wondering. I'm just wondering what the red eye is for. Oh, I'm not even... I'm locked on the wrong one. Oh, well. Brass feminist suit. Oh, shit! Holy fuck. Watch out for that thing. Level 39. Don't even look at that thing. Look at that thing the wrong way, it might murder your soul. I'm guessing since this is a Femina Swid, it's not going to give me what I want. Not going to give me what I need. Either way, let's just finish murdering it and maybe get what I need. I want to kill the red one. Maybe the red one is an enemy we haven't killed before? Is that what it is? I'm not sure. Or maybe if you kill that one, it aggroes all the rest? I'm just trying to decide what the red eyeball thing means on an enemy. All yo shit, girl. Give me all yo shit, girl. Gonna collect these. Oh my god, there's gems for days over here. I'm gonna collect all these bitches. Gems for days. Gems for days. Not sure what all these things. Phobe, gems for days. I'm gonna try to stay away from anything giant that will murder me. Try being the operative word. Need more of the enemies that had an exclamation point over their head? Guess not. Dude, there's so many fucking blue dots out here. I love it. You can move so fast. Collecting them all doesn't seem like such a daunting task. I'm getting a ton of fuel tanks, by the way. Like a ton of them. Hopefully I need a lot of them for something. So I'm getting a ton of them. Centrifugal beam generator. Centrifugal. However you want to pronounce it. Where am I going right now? I'm just running out here like a maniac. I can just fast travel back to the city, right? Let's try it. Let's give it a go. How do we fast travel? I think if we hit them, no. Sorry, I'm using my map right now. I'm trying to figure out how to fast travel. How do I fast travel back to the city? Back to the city. We want to go to the administrative district, I believe, and how do we fast travel back there? Yeah, we want to go to the maintenance center. Wow, this is going to be super fun for me to watch me do this, because I'm sitting here on my goddamn fucking screen trying to fast travel and shit. But you know what? Learning, it's the only way. This map is very detailed, though. I like it a lot. I'm a fan. Alright, we're back where we need to be. The girl who we did this quest for is right here? Where's she at? Is she not spawned yet? Is she not here at this time of day? What's going on? Do we have to... She is here. Okay. I was like, sometimes you gotta wait till the draw thing happens. You gotta wait a sec. Alright, Kirsty, I did your quest. The probes are installed and set up as mining probes. Perfect! You work fast. I'm sure that's part of what Nagy sees in you. Hell yeah, baby. Tyrol. All right there, rookie. Don't go getting a big head. This stuff should be easy. Try setting your comms device display to Frontier Nav mode. You should see the three sides circled in red connected by link lines. Okay. That's a three-site link combo. It boosts the effects of each of those data probes by 30%. If you get that link combo up to 5 neighboring sites, with the same data probe, effects will be by 50%, and an 80%. You see where this is going? The more data probes of the same type you install in neighboring placement sites, the more efficient Frontier Nav and your related assignments will be. So, think you got a hang of all this chaining data probe jazz? Sure. I got the idea of how it works, but, like, what's the point of it? I don't get the point of it yet. Swift pupils make teaching a pleasure. Well, then, I'd say that concludes your first assignment. You can have this research probe by the way of reward. Don't say I never gave you anything. I'll teach you about that one next, okay? Alright, we'll start the same way. I'll point you to a new frontier in the probe site, and you'll go install a probe. Then you'll see quantum mystery, blah, 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 blah. And on top of that, I want you to find an unexplored territory known as the Rock Cavern. Good luck. Alright, well, I guess that means you got a new quest for us. Alright. Fair enough. So we technically have another one. Yeah, we do. It's already down there. Install at the new place. Discover the Rock Cavern. Alright. It's undiscovered. I know exactly where it is on the map, though. Okay, well, let's test out our new fast travel techniques by, let's go to the map. NLA. No. World. We want to go to Primordia. I think where we want to go... Where's the yellow on our map? I don't know, sure where the arrow is pointing us. Wait, where is it pointing us? Doesn't really tell us on here, does it? Well, I mean... Huh. Where we want to go and where we need... Okay, yeah, it actually does show us where we need to go. Alright, we want to go and fast travel here, I think. Fast travel to there. Okay, you can fast travel by clicking the hexagons on the map. Alright. Yeah, I really wish you guys could see my map. It'd be really nice, but... Don't think that's going to be an option here, children. Oh, well. Let's go explore some more hexagons. What do you say? Run like a BZ to the CZ. Run like a BZ, gonna murder all these BZs. Wait, let's kill this thing. It might give me something cool. Kill the Grex. Actually, not sure which enemies I need to kill for quests and stuff. I hope they're just all marked and I'm just wasting my time killing this guy. So I'm kind of hopeful. Boom, bitch! Ooh. Young Grex got toppled, son. Boom! It's on! Young Grex just rocked your dome! I love how big the enemies are in this game. It's just so cool, the scope of the game. It just, for how big the world is, it just makes sense. I love it. Makes it seem like these fucking creatures belong in this world. And we're just, like, we're literally on a planet that doesn't, it's not made for humans, that's for damn sure. Let's move. Anyway, other than we are smarter than what lives here and we can murder them without fear? I don't know, without a care in the world. Anyway, collecting blue things. I'm assuming if we finish one of these quests of collecting things, it'll just kind of just happen. It'll be like, yo, you finished the quest, good job. I'm gonna walk out for that giant crab scorpion looking thing. Not look like that thing is gonna be a fan of me. Hey, I found roof rock. I don't think that's the rock we're looking for, but hey, whatever. This place looks pretty cool. I'm assuming we can climb up to the top. There's also some pretty low-level fireflies flying around here. What is with the red? Does this just mean I haven't killed this enemy before? Maybe that's what that means. Let's kill it and find out. A grassland Skirpo. Ooh, got rocks, Skirpo. What you know about getting rocks, Skirpo? Boom, Skirpo. What you know about that Skirpo? That Skirpo. Mm-hmm, that Skirpo. Mm-hmm, that Skirp. Alright, I know how to switch between weapons now. You just gotta press the X button. Switches you between. It says it right there on the damn screen on the right, and I didn't even notice. We can actually target different appendages, too? I mean, for this enemy, I don't know if that's the case, but it looks like that's the case that we can do that. I should pay attention to all the little things on my screen that are telling me what to do. I might actually learn something. Who knows? Anyway, I'm gonna kill another one of these things. Get over here, Grassland Skirpo. Kill another one of you. I don't know why. I'm just going to kill another one because I feel like it. Get him. Get him. I missed the topple. He wasn't staggered yet. It's alright. Just fuck him up. Just chop his sack. Just blow his sack to bits. Blow his sack. You heard me. He doesn't need that. There it is. Get the sack. Get it. Get it. No, get the sack, damn it. Move in and strike. How do I make hit the sack on purpose? I'm not sure, but the sack is now gone, so it doesn't matter. That giant fucking Skirpo bitch. You don't get away from me, damn it. You scare me. Son. Oh god, pressed a heck of late, but I still got it. Just die! There you go. Fuck, man. That thing did not want to die. And we got a level up. Sweet, we're level 8 now. Awesome. Now, I kind of want to pick up that blue dot, but that guy is scaring me. Wait, what's the yellow over here? This is one of those collectible items, right? Let's go ahead and... I think I walked right by this on the map. I saw the little red, yellow square, but I wasn't sure what it was. I didn't actually look. It's one of these things. Found me a treasure. And it's... something. 2,000 credits. Alright, cool. I'll take it. This game is so fucking pretty, I can play it all day. Whoop de doo 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 doo. I'm gonna run around cause I'm fucking having so much fun. Whee! Jumping across the plains. Jumping like a crazy mane. Collecting blue dots. Oh man, how I missed thee. Whoa. I have to kill this thing? I'm not high enough level to kill this thing yet. Not sure why I gotta kill you, sir. But you're on the list. And trust me, you don't want to be on this list. But I do want to go over there to that probe spot and fucking probe the hell out of that. So let's do that real quick. Just don't aggro the big motherfucker. He'll fucking murder me right now. I am nowhere near the level I need to be aggroing with these big fucks right now. I'm just a lowly level 8. Lowly level 8 doesn't fuck with level 22s, man. I will lose with 22s in this case. Anyway, let's probe the fuck out of this. Can we probe it? Wait, what? Can I not, do I not have what I need to probe this shit, or what? I'm a little worried that it wouldn't let me probe that. I'm hoping it's just because I'm not supposed to yet. I'm not sure. God, I hope what I have what I need to probe this shit. The one that we're supposed to probe. Or I'm just dumb and I don't have what I need. In which case, well, that's great. Just going around to trying to do things that you can't actually do right now. And did I mention that this game is beautiful? God, I could say that every 2 seconds, and it would still be true, because this game is fucking beautiful. I'm just gonna collect all the blue dots, because hell yeah. Hell yeah. Ooh, what's this? This looks fancy. It looks like a... Aw, I'm not high enough level. What level is it? It's a level 2. We need to be level 2! How do I get level 2? I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. Level 17 enemies. Might want to stay away from them. Right now, at this point, I'm just following the arrow. Stay away from level 17 and 18. They will fuck your shit up. Just follow toward the yellow arrow. Stay away from 22s, because you will lose. Even though I was taught to... You can't lose with 22s. You don't want to fuck with a 22. Alright, looks like I collected... something I needed, a vagabond ant. Just keep collecting blue things, you'll eventually finish some quests. There's a lot of different items in this area. Is there like a book that tells me how many items there are in an area, or is it just literally random? I'm scared to go down there, by the way, and it looks like we need to go down there too. Let's do it. Whee! Ow. Oh, we lived. Silent Mire, okay. We'll see if this was a good idea in a minute. I don't like that electrical thing. I think it's going to fuck me up. I think I see the cave. It was called a cave, right? Rock cave or something? I'm going to hope that this is where we need to go. It looks like that might be the case. Yeah, rock cavern. That's what it was called. It was called rock cavern. Whoa, it's full of... Okay. Full of things that we don't want to even fuck with right now. We'll have to check that out on at a different time. But now that it's discovered, we may be able to... Well, I think you can't... I don't know, can you fast travel to an area, or does it have to be a... It probably has to be marked with a probe. That's fine. We're probably going to install a probe nearby here, so it's okay. Damn it, level 2 again. We need level 2! How do you get level 2? Archaeological or whatever. I'm sure there's a way. I could probably upgrade it right now, and I don't even realize it. It's probably something in the menu that all I got to do is go do. But I'm too busy having fun running around the world and... just jumping like a goddamn maniac. Don't you dare fox with me, sirs. Because I won't fox with you if you don't fox with me. I want to... Oh, God, I want to pick up all these things. I'm greedy right now. I'm greedy. Getting greedy. Getting greedy. I just want to see if I can collect all the things I need, man. And if even if I don't collect what I need right now, it's all going to help for later. Which is what I'm really hoping for. To do all the do all the busy work now. It'll only help later. That was a big part of Xenoblade Chronicles. Fuck. Shit. Run. Run, girl, run. I don't know what's chasing you, but you don't want to fuck with it. Run like hell. Don't even. Don't fuck around. Just get the hell out of here. Nope, I'm dead. Shit. Shit, really? Guess we're returning. We got wrecked. Last landmark was the cave, right? Fuck, that might be bad. That might be bad. So when you die, it actually resets, right? Like, stuff you picked up is gone. You have to pick it up again. It seems like that's the case. Either that or I just got spawned in a direction that I wasn't paying attention and I didn't pick up all these items before. I don't know. Either way, I'm picking up the items again because I want to. I might have to teleport out of here then, because I don't know if I can get out of here without fighting unless I be really, really careful and walk around the edge. If I trailer park girl around the outside this shit, I might be able to get out of here safely. Who knows? Two trailer park girls go around the outside. Around the outside. Well, actually, I got three of them, so three trailer park girls go around the outside. Around the outside. Around the outside. Two trailer park girls go around the outside. Around the outside. Okay. So, grab that and run this way. Don't you dare. Don't you dare aggro a damn thing. I'm not running through the middle of any of that this time. Going around the inside. Around the outside with the trailer park girls. Stay away from the enemies. Stay away from the summoner! Alright. Do I want to go... Where do I want to go? I want to get up there, I think. I think I might have to go that way to get up there, though. That's the problem. Seems to be the conundrum. That's what I get for jumping down off the damn cliff. So I might have to teleport or something? Or just run around in a big-ass circle to find my way back up there. I don't know. I'm having too much fun exploring and just seeing all these fucking things. It's just... I don't even want to teleport, man. I just want to run. I want to run from A to B, man. I want to run like this ostrich over here. I know they're not ostriches, but they run like an ostrich. Okay, I think we can get up the hill over here. This'll do, Dunkey. That'll do. This'll do right here. Get us on top of that cliff. Head toward that yellow arrow. That can be my last goal for today's episode, is get to that probe. Stick that probe in that flow. Get the power of teleportation. Teleportation. Ready to fly and be free. God, this game is so fucking beautiful. Do-do-do-do, Scooby-Doo. Music's a lot more funky in this game than it was in the previous Xenoblade. Not in a bad way or anything like that. I'm just saying it's more funky. I like it. Oh fuck, oh fuck, oh fuck. Run. Run. Level 14, that's still too high. We don't fox with the 14. Run from the little squid. The little squid will murder us. That's a bad little squid. That's a bad little squid. Aha, we discovered the West Gen Path plane. Gen Path? Gen Path. That is what it says. Alright, well, whoa, is this a live thing? This tree looked alive for a second there. I think it may have been at some point. Okay, actually, I think this is the probe we need to probe, right? Fuck, there's like big enemies right on top of it. Level 92! Holy fuck, it's like an ankylosaur. Fucking cool looking. Oh my god. There's such hard... Why are there... Oh my god, there's big ass enemies around here. I don't like it. Can we not aggro them, please? Whoa. Effin sight 17. Yeah, that's an effin sight, alright. Effin scary. Quick! Probe it! Probe it! Quickly! Yes! Maybe I wasn't high enough level to actually probe that other one. Maybe that's what it was. Anyway, install it, and then we have to make it a research probe? Is that what she said? Oh, I just... did I just fast travel to the spot I'm already at? I think I did. Alright, change probe to research probe. Confirm. Boom! Alright, let's go talk to Kirstie Alley. Yo, Kirstie! Hey, yo, Kirstie. How do I teleport over there again? I had it down. Oh, sorry. It's over here. Duh. Duh. Das Vidanya. Duh. There we go. Yeah, the places inside of the main city, NLA, are marked on like the side of the main world map, so you can just glow right there real quick. at least in terms of districts. The districts are all split up real nice. We'll have to go explore the rest of the districts if you want to fast travel around there, though. But anyway, What's-Her-Face should respawn now. Kirsty, I'm here to turn in my quest fest, and that'll be the end of the episode. And we haven't even scratched the surface on this game, man. I am so excited for this. This is the kind of game that will consume my world when I get really into it. Anyway, welcome back. The Rock Cavern seems like a mystical place. We'll go back there later. Folks in here in town will all be blown. We're all blown away by it. Hey, you seem curious to see how they could have seen it without even leaving NLA. Well, by accessing the research probe you installed, they can view the data it's amassed. For the civilians living here, that's their only way of learning about the outside world. The probes you're installing aren't just a way to track down parts of the White Whale's lifehold. Sure, they serve as a source of hope for the future, but they're also helping people today. I hope that underscores just how important your work is. Make sense?
Totally.
Broadly. I like the fire in your eyes. And you'll also receive sightseeing points if a lot of people access your research probes. New blades need all sorts of equipment, and a little extra income never hurts. Discovering unexplored territories like Flat Rock Cavern will get lots of people to access your research probes, so keep an eye out for them. What else am I forgetting? As you install more probes, Meranium mining should also pick up steam. You may eventually reach the limit of how much Meranium you can hold. In that case, setting special data probes known as storage probes can help. They'll raise the limit of how much Meranium you can store. Let me give you one now as thanks for showing me that unexplored territory I wouldn't have otherwise seen. Alright, cool. Mission complete. Whoop, whoop. Just remember that, like any data probe simply carrying around the storage probe won't do you any good. You'll need to put it to actual use. So access your comm device at a Frontier Nav probe. Change to install probe to a storage probe. Phew, that should cover the basics. When more Frontier Nav assignments come across my desk, I'll be sure to send them your way. Each one of them spreads Rooster and Marin further. Yay! We did it! We leveled up! Woot woot! We are now level 9! Woot woot! We are now level 9! Woot woot! Alright. So, it put me back on the Chapter 3 quest, but I think in the next episode, we're just going to keep doing side quest stuff, I think. I'm kind of one of those people who likes to do all the side shit before he continues on with the story, and especially since our current main quest is just to go rescue some people or something, it's not like... Oh man, the story is grabbing me already. It hasn't really. We haven't even scratched the surface, like I said. We don't even know what the story really is of this game yet. We know the setting. We've met some of the characters, but we don't know the real story yet. What will be the story? Will the story really kick in when we find out what actually inhabits this planet that's more like humans than we are? We're going to find out eventually, I'm sure. I'm thinking there has to be, because the whole point is they went to explore some ruins that looked like they were man-made and not natural. And that's where the real story is going to kick in. I can feel it already. Anyways, I'm going to stop babbling with my coffee-ass brain today. Or I should say caffeinated ass. Whatever, dude. Shut up already. In the next episode, we're probably going to do more side quest shit. Probably not going to make it to the main quest, but I won't promise either one way or the other. In the meantime, peace easy beezies.